Buying a vehicle in the Wabash Valley has never been so easy. Just point, click, and take your pick at DorsetAutomotive.com. New or pre-owned, you call the shots. Go ahead and give it a try. Point, click, and take your pick now at DorsetAutomotive.com.
Conference basketball season. And join us right now, the boys from Indiana State, Coach Greg Lansing, Christian Smith, Devontae Brown. Guys, how you doing? Thanks for joining us.
Appreciate it.
Coach taking it easy on you right now, or is he really running your ragged?
I don't know if we can say that out loud right now.
You already set it up, Christian.
We're working pretty hard, though.
All right, let's talk about last year first. I mean, you were preseason number 6. You wind up 3rd. I know the ending was a bad taste in all your guys' mouth, but you had to feel good about what transpired last year, doing what you did, Greg, during the regular season.
Well, we had 7 new guys going into the year, although we had some veterans back, and it was a struggle for a while. You lose a player like Jake Odom, who basically had the ball in his hands the majority of the time on the offensive end, and you lose some great leadership in that. We had to learn a lot of lessons, a lot of tough lessons. We had a difficult, probably too difficult, a preseason schedule, and that's my fault. That's just kind of the way we always do it. At Christmas, I was considering a different profession, I know that, but these two really stepped up and took over, and Devontae obviously had the type of year where he was all conference, and we did okay in the league. I mean, we did okay in the league. Finishing 3rd is certainly not our goal, but had 2 top 10 teams in the league that were awfully good.
Yeah, no doubt about it. How about you, Devontae? I mean, all the success that you had last year, I mean, you carry that forward from what you did personally and from a team aspect?
I mean, I don't really pay attention to it. We don't pay attention to last year. It's a whole new year, new guys, new slate. It's just, we got to just worry about the positive things right now and just focus on getting better. Don't even worry about last year.
Christian, former 6th man of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference, your senior season. It goes by quick, doesn't it?
Yeah, a little too quick.
So for both you and Devontae, you carrying on this leadership role now to help coach out a little bit?
Yeah, just a little bit. We're just being ourselves. Devontae said it before. I mean, we're just doing things that we've always done since we've been here, just taking the role that coach has always put in us and just teaching the new guys, you know, little things here and there to try to keep coach off of them a little bit in practice. So, you know, things have been going by really well, and we're just trying to continue to work hard.
Well, I'm curious because, as we just talked about, it goes so fast. I mean, for you, Devontae, any pressure because this is it? This is your last year in college to try to succeed as best as you can?
There's not really any pressure. I mean, we've been playing basketball all our lives, so it shouldn't be pressure. It hasn't been pressure when we were little, so it shouldn't be pressure now. So we're just having fun and listening to what Coach is saying every day and getting better.
Christian?
Yeah, no pressure. We try not to think about it. You know, maybe in my room by myself, I think a little pressure. But, you know, out there on the court, just like he says, just having fun, just trying to win games.
All right, Coach, you got 3 returning starters from last year's team. What's the expectations for this year?
Our expectations are always high. We want to be relevant at the end of the year. We're not a team that just sets a bunch of goals. Our goal is to get better every day. We know what the gauntlet is ahead of us. And when you got seniors like these two and then Brandon Burnett, these two have they're all conference type guys, and so is Brenton Scott, who was a freshman of the year last year. They're working awfully hard. We don't have to go in and cheerlead every day. These guys are tremendous leaders and tremendous players. I know what they expect, and they put in the off season to where they deserve great things to happen, and we're just hoping that does.
You mentioned Brenton. Boy, what an addition he was for your team, and now he's got 1 year under his belt already.
Yeah, he's a lot like the head coach. He's got a screw loose, and I got a screw loose, so these guys, they do a great job with Brenton's a scorer. He's a tremendous scorer. He's on the verge of being out of control at all times, but he plays. He's coming along with his concepts on the defensive end, and we'll butt head at times, but he's an awfully talented player.
Okay, we talked to, obviously, the 2 seniors that are with you. What about some new guys that folks in the Valley can take a look out for that's going to help your team this year?
Now, we lost T.J. Bell, who had been our starting 5 before the year ever started, but we have a lot of good pieces. We really do, and in that 5 spot, the center spot or the other forward spot, we're going to be young a little bit, but I look at the additions we made with the junior colleges guys, and Everett Clemens coming from Vincennes Community College and Niels Bunshoden from Howard Community College. Those guys were well coached in junior college. They came right in and fit in tremendously. They're great communicators, tremendous workers. So we really added something there, and they're going to be good for us. And we're going to have a lot. We're going to play a lot of guys. We're going to play a lot of guys. We're as deep as we've been since I've been there. We're as talented as we've been. So the expectations are pretty high for us.
All right. Obviously, as we get set for the new season, as you all know, and I'm sure Coach has been working it with you, is the new rules, a lot of new rules in college basketball. I'll start with you guys first before I get to the coach. Christian, start with you. Some of the new rules that you guys are going to have to work on to make the adjustments for this year.
Well, we don't have to worry about the 30-second shot clock because we don't even get that far. So, you know, with us three, with Brenton too, so we're getting that thing up quick. But it's been an adjustment, though. That 5 seconds has really been an adjustment. But we like to play fast and get the ball up and down the floor really well. So, I mean, it's really fun, actually. It's better for our play.
Devontae, obviously your game is the score, but again, it also has an effect as far as defending as well.
Absolutely. It's causing headaches in practice, I can tell you that. Everybody's getting called for a foul, for, you know, hand checking and things like that. But it's a huge adjustment, just like Christian said. And, you know, we've been watching a lot of film on how the new rules is going to be playing out. So coach is sticking to making sure we do it right. So we're just going to keep working at it.
A coach's son is Greg Lansing, so your thoughts on all these changes that we're seeing, probably more dramatic than I can at least remember the last several years.
Anything that makes our game better, I'm for. I'm all for keep working it towards the NBA rules. I really am. I think it's great. And this freedom of movement stuff, I'm surprised Christian doesn't have his forearm out right now to check the defender. That's going to be a tough one, and it was a couple years when they implemented it. I like the shortening the shot clock, those things. Some of the other rules, I think we're just going to continue to keep tweaking the game, but anything that's for the betterment of the game, I'm all for it.
Let's talk about this conference. And you guys finished third. Talk about Northern Iowa and Wichita State before the season's over with both top 10 teams. I mean, this day in and day out, you can even go to the teams that are even preseason 9-10. You guys have your hands full every night, it seems like, Christian.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what your pick, what it is. I mean, every day you got to come to battle. I mean, it doesn't matter if you're 10th or first. You know, you can lose it any given day, and that's what we work on every day, not to give up any days in practice, just like you can't give up any games. So, I mean, we're just working hard just to make sure we're staying focused each day because, you know, the Valley's tough. You know, people don't give us enough credit at each team. So, I mean, any day you can be beat.
Real quick, before we let you guys go, Greg, with you. What are the keys to Indiana State's success this year?
For one, staying healthy. It really is. And we just have to continue to, and it's going to be that way for everybody. Everybody needs to stay healthy. But I feel we're as good as we've been in our tenure. And we've in our tenure, we're third in the league in Valley wins. And you're behind Northern Iowa and Wichita. But us staying healthy, and our goal is always, like these guys have said, that's the way they're built. It's get better every day, and there's nobody that's worked harder than these two. So if we stay healthy and continue to improve throughout, bring these young guys along, we're going to be a tough opponent.
Devontae, Christian, Greg, thanks so much. Appreciate it. Best of luck to you guys coming up in 2015-16.